In this course, you will get an introduction into making augmented reality apps using ARKit, RealityKit, and SwiftUI. Hey Code Crew, this is Flo. This is the first lesson of the ARKit course. In this lesson, you will set up your Xcode project for AR, dabble with a custom ARView, a UI view representable for that ARView, and then you will end up with an empty augmented reality screen. First of all, when you create your project, there are basically two options. There is the easy route where you select augmented reality app as your application, or you select a simple SwiftUI app. This is what I have done in the example project that I already created, which is completely empty. But just so you know, I did not start with an augmented reality app. I started with a regular SwiftUI app, and we will add all of these AR features ourselves. Okay, so first of all, for your understanding, an augmented reality app is basically just a single view. All of the augmented reality stuff happens in a so-called AR view, which is from ARKit, but it's very similar to UIKit. So in order to use it in SwiftUI, we will have to create our own UI view representable. But since we want to customize that AR view with some extra functionality, for example, to play some 3D entities in the scene, we will actually create our custom AR view. And that's the first thing that we will do right after creating a new group here. And I like to always create a feature targets group that basically sorts the app by each feature. So for example, a settings group, inside of that, a home feed group, a user profile group, and so on. Now in our case, I will just put everything inside of the feature targets group that I just created. So in here, we will start with our custom AR view. Next, we will build our AR view representable. And then lastly, we will add that into our SwiftUI view and get it all running for a very basic starter application. So let's hit Command N and let's create a new Swift file. And we will call it custom AR view. Now in here, we don't need to import foundation. Instead, we can import ARKit. And then for later on, we can already import RealityKit and SwiftUI. We will need all three of those later on. There will be a lot happening in the future lessons in this exact file. Okay, so we will create a class called custom ARView, which inherits from ARView. So usually you would directly use ARView in your app, but we will create this custom ARView so we can add some functionality in there. If you subclass from a UIKit view, there are two initializers that you need to implement. So the first one is init from a frame, and here we will just call super.init with that frame that we got passed in. So basically we call our ARView initializer, and then we also need the init from a coder. I think this is the one, and I think you also have to specify that it is dynamic. Doesn't really matter for our context. And then in here, we're not implementing this. This is basically decoding this class, which we will never have to do. So we will just throw a fatal error saying init with a coder has not been implemented. Okay. And then we will also implement a third initializer, and this is the one that we will actually use. So we will make it a convenience init, and it takes in no arguments. It's a convenience initializer because this one will actually call another initializer, and it will call the self.init with a frame, and we will just pass in the entire screen bounds. So our ARView will fill out the full screen. We will also be able to handle that in SwiftUI later on. Okay, so this is our custom ARView. Right now you might not understand why we need it, because it basically does nothing except for extending ARView. And you're right, right now it's totally not needed, but in the future we will build on top of this and add some more functions in here that will then hopefully make more sense to you. Okay, next up we will create the view representable so we can actually use this custom ARView in our SwiftUI code. So let's right click on feature targets and hit new file, Swift file, and this one will have a very long name. You will probably want to choose a different name here. So I will call it custom ARView representable. And then let's copy that name. Okay. In here, we just need to import SwiftUI. Now this will not be a class since we're not in UIKit land anymore. Now we're in SwiftUI land, so it will be a struct, our custom ARView representable, and this one of course needs to conform to the protocol UIViewRepresentable, which basically means that we can use this in a SwiftUI views body. If you implement UIViewRepresentable, you need to have two functions. The first one is makeUIView, and the second one is updateUIView. I think we will never actually use the update function, so we will just leave that one empty. And then the makeUIView, we will basically just return the view that we just created, so our custom ARView. So we can just say return custom ARView, and now here we can use our convenience initializer with no arguments, this one that we defined here in line 16 basically. And then we can also copy this type name and replace the SumUIView with that and this UIView type as well, just so compiling might be a tiny bit faster because Xcode doesn't have to resolve this type by themselves. Okay, now already the second to last thing for this lesson is to move content view into our feature targets group as well. Once again, you can call this group whatever you want. You could also call it AR views or AR components, or you could even not have a group at all. It's just a bit better organized like this. So in our content view, now we have already done all of the hard work, so we can now use our representable here and actually display it to the user. So we have our custom ARView representable, and then we did specify the UI screen main bounds here as the frame, but in SwiftUI it will by default not ignore the safe areas, but we actually want the camera part of the app to basically stretch from the very top to the very bottom of the screen, so we'll add the ignores safe area modifier here in the end as well. Now I already spoiled it because an AR view basically is a camera stream, right? And if you want to use a camera, you need to add a privacy description in your info.plist file. So that is basically the last thing that we have to set up now. So let's go into our project file, select our target on the left, and then click info in the top navigation bar here. And then for any of these entries, it really doesn't matter. Click any of these plus icons, and in here you can search for privacy camera usage description. And in here we can just add any kind of string. So you could, for example, say needed to show AR view. This is basically the string that's shown to the user when they asked for permission to use the camera. Okay, so now we have our basic project set up, and when you run the app, then you will only see a camera stream, no text elements, no entities anywhere, nothing, just a plain camera view, but you will already know that this is not just a camera, this is actually our custom AR view, which inherits from AR view. So this is basically an empty augmented reality app that we have now created with our custom view and our view representable. In this lesson, you started to set up your Xcode project for working with ARKit, and you created the core infrastructure that you will need in the next lessons.